Hi everyone, welcome back to the Prophecies of Victor the Budgie, where you can hear real budgies channeling hidden messages from the angels. Welcome back. This presentation is a third part of the Superconscious Bird. I know that there are some of you out there listening because I got 20 views in the first hour when I posted that last video of Victor in the forum. I hope you are the ones analyzing and verifying the videos. It's a little funny, but I just saw a post where someone made a comment that the reverse parts are just dubbed over with forward speech. That's ridiculous, but at least the skeptics are admitting they're hearing some of it. I will leave a link to the raw video file of the Superconscious Bird part 1 to 3 so you can dissect and reverse the parts yourself. That way you can see that there is no manipulation going on with the reverse speech. You'll have to make sure that you cut the forward speech at the exact place I do in order to get the reversal correct. So, some of you have noticed that we're doing some miraculous things here at Sentinels of the Future. We are translating both forward and reverse speech of budgies, resulting in almost perfect context. Some of you know it is a first, especially when you are beginning to witness the miracle for yourself. Some will find that as you listen to the recordings, you open a part of your soul that helps you become more spiritual. And the more you listen to them, the more you evolve in your understanding. Some of you may start having prophetic dreams and visions, and you will have a better understanding of what really exists in other dimensions. God and His angels are personally connected when they begin to communicate to you through dreams and visions. So this is truly food for the soul. And the more you listen and understand, the more nourished your soul will be. So don't give up if you don't understand everything yet. Keep on listening because it does get a lot easier. This is the final part of the Superconscious Bird, and everything seems to come together quite nicely, and we're very excited about bringing it to others. It has 33 parts in all. So in part 1 to 4, this is what he says. Someday you'll get your tall big seat, and you'll see everywhere, and then I say in reverse, and time is really special. This is done easily, and most have real passion. In part 2, he says, with God, we wait by the sun, haha, climb into our ship with a view that seeks with spirit. In it, you shall see what Ryan saw, a special view that seemed impossible. You will follow some spirituality in everything. And in part 3, he says, a lot we do during your induction process here, fearlessly, is a quest to identify what we know is here also. And in part 4, he says, we'll cross through legendary evil on a course that's very difficult. Can you reach in to this beautiful process here with some help? So now you can hear parts 1 to 4.
What's that? What are you looking at? What are you looking at, Victor? What's that you're looking at? Huh? I need to leave. It's a flower, eh? What's Betty saying? What's he up to?
That was the end of part 1 to 4, and this is the intro for 5 to 8. Victor makes an interesting and profound statement when he says we'll be crossing through some legendary evil in that last part. I already experienced some of it yesterday when someone made a comment on YouTube that was full of vulgarities and religious evil. In parts 5 to 8, he mentions that souls are speaking to us and the interlink is here and part of life. He talks about Fuzzy, a budgie that I had just before Victor, who is also an incredible talker. He flew out the door one day when I was gone for a few days, and my wife and son were coming home from shopping. Our relationship was similar to that of what I had with Victor, and he was a very friendly and brave budgie who would go to any extent to play with me. I can remember him biting my toes when I was lying on the couch sleeping so that I would wake up and play with him. Or when I was working out doing push-ups on the floor, he would fly on my back for a ride. So this is what Victor said in parts 5 to 8. What we are hearing is every soul that's requesting this recording in time. Now that you know what is here, we shall begin. In part 6 he says, you'll find this inner link is sitting here. We know it sure can be an inset of life. In part 7, as we think and talk to special and a free part in us, it is part of the possible. Fuzzy, who flew away, is a soul that endeared a relationship with Ryan. He knew that God had chose this bird person in this world. Passionately, his heart chose to look for him. Now you can hear parts 5 to 8.
Going back to part 4, we want to point out a few more examples of the legendary evil that Victor talks about and what we'll have to watch out for while we're on this journey. So these are ways that individuals or groups try to suppress the truth from those that are searching for it. And this often happens when it comes to trying to hide the existence of God or the spiritual world. In 2018, we have heard the phrase collusion quite a bit when it comes to President Trump. It means secret or illegal cooperation of individuals to deceive others. And this deception becomes much easier to do when using the internet. For example, when a forum is quiet, like the one we have right now, all it takes is a couple of people who have their own reasons for personal gain to get together and cause issues so others won't believe what the truth really is. We can think of many reasons why the discovery of incredible animal intelligence like we have demonstrated here would cause issues for certain organizations. Infiltration within a group also occurs when individuals come pretending to be someone they are not and waiting for an opportunity to discredit or spread lies about the subject matter. False statements on the internet are also ways to convince others that something is not true when it is. For example, for almost 10 years, the Museum of Hoaxes has had a post saying that Victor was a hoax. And if you do a search, it is one of the first things that comes up on the internet. Obviously, Museum of Hoaxes has been left up and paid for by someone who is trying to discredit the work Ryan has been doing with the budgies. Unfortunately, because it is high on the rankings, it causes people to doubt Ryan's work right from the get-go. Experts who have published subject matter that contradicts new research such as Ryan's is another way that they use to discredit new discoveries. This has happened to Ryan before, when Mailer was answering real-time questions in a popular forum. When the thread began to have a large number of viewers, they brought in a so-called expert on parrot intelligence that disputed Ryan's findings. In addition, several other people mysteriously arrived and began making rude comments and jokes about what was happening. We apologize for using the words so-called expert, but when you know that your research in an area proves something that an expert claims is not true, then they assume the role of a so-called expert in our books. Scientific confirmation is another ploy they use to dismiss something as incredible as this, saying there is no scientific proof. even when it is staring them right in the face. Additionally, when you try and get the scientific community to validate it, there are few who want to get involved because it could affect their reputation or even go against their own findings. Making small issues big ones is another form of changing the subject and hiding the truth. Sure, we all make mistakes, and there are individuals who will question you on every little mistake or event in the past that could have been done in a better way, making it sound far worse than it really is. Inappropriate messages with members who support the research is another way that some individuals use to spread lies and cause confusion. They may find the email addresses of as many supporters as they can so they can contact them and express their negative and false opinions. There are even programs out there that will hijack your email address and send messages to your contacts, making them think that you said something in the email you shouldn't have. Making a mockery of someone by using teasing and contemptuous language so others will side with them is something that has happened too. It is also used to taunt someone into getting upset and saying something they shouldn't. And then there is harassment, which is quite hard to source when they use fictitious names and even change their names so they can come back to the forum and continue where they left off. We have ways of blocking them. However, if they have computers in different locations or VPNs, they can come back multiple times. So who is trying to suppress knowledge and truth from us? I am not going to say that the government is playing an active role in preventing us from knowing the truth about many things, but there is definitely a force out there working against us when it comes to discovering the truth. When things like this happen, it makes it difficult for people to trust the ones that really are trying to disclose the truth.
So in part 9 to 12, Victor says, in part 9, he's talking about Fuzzy here. He knew he missed him and was lured away towards a storm and captured by a boy. In our view, if you've been lost, you will need love from heaven. And then I say, and we're close now. We also agree, and in part 10 he says, it's important to inform you, God is good to people who are still looking. You will emotionally be able to know when you learn the truth. And in part 11, this grand seat has its goal. It's to take you forward. We think we can get your heart right on a better course in life. We'd love to, and in part 12 he says, find all of you sublime trust in him. Now you can hear parts 9 to 12.
You're a good flyer. You flew up there today.
In parts 13 to 16, Victor talks about other budgies that will come to me in the future at 150. 150 is the address we live at right now, and Danny was here already, as Victor prophesied. He said these budgies will be on a mission with me, and that their ability to talk in context is a major discovery. It's also interesting how I call them heroes, and they should be praised or thanked for their effort. Victor and the other budgies have always stayed away from anything that asks for some kind of budgie worship, which we will not do here. We are here to listen to and learn from the words of God and the angels, and the budgies are channeling them to us. So in part 13 he says, praise those birds who talk in a song to pass you by your confusion. And then I say, some parrots, they ought to be heroes. In part 14, there will come some that get to talk, and shall take a piece of me. and most agree with Ryan on the mission. And in part 15, he says, they'll understand the parrots that come. And of course, they can defer the mic. To have intelligence just like it's human is really major. And in part 16, he says, please come to 150. There will still be more on a mission to help him. You'll see. Now you can hear parts 13 to 16.
Good boy. Keep it up. You're talking nice.
In parts 17 to 20, Victor talks about the budgies that I will have in the future, and how some will even be better at speaking than him. Both Mailer and Danny learn much from Victor's recordings, and some say they are even clearer than Victor was. I will be doing a presentation soon of Danny. I have many of Victor's left, but the angels have prompted me to change to Danny for a while and come back to Victor in later presentations. Victor also said that these budgies will be connected to a simple man like Christ was. Although Christ was only a simple carpenter by trade, in our view, he was one of the greatest prophets who lived, and I humble myself when the angels make comparisons. I know I could never be as great as he was. That does not mean, however, that through me, Christ cannot teach the lessons that he needed to teach humanity before he moved on, and we have been told in the past that Christ is one of the angels helping us with this religion from God. Victor actually talks about how Christ will be helping us here to reverse our evil and reach heaven. In the last part, he talks about getting the captions validated and hints to the fact that God will let them be validated when the time is right. So in part 17, he says, you'll see budgies he enlisted, and some will be better at providing their voice. They'll have a family that gives them much. And some really see, as in part 18, their efforts deepen, it's guaranteed to have videos up connected to a simple man like Christ was. Yes, he was a man who was trying to help us reverse our evil and reach heaven. In part 19, he says, God helps and promises us he'll be doing it for us to trust and believe we evolve in heaven. In part 20, he says, when he lets the captions be validated, many will give us help. So now you can hear part 17 to 20. In parts 21 to 24, Victor talks about how it took Linda quite a while before she fully began to understand the translation. When she did, it helped me resume passion in continuing because I was getting discouraged when the group left me. He also talks about the superconscious birds that came after him. Of course, they are Mailer and Danny, who both have the same incredible ability for prophecy and speech. He talks about the group I was working with at the time, who thought I should not be doing reversals or taking such a focused spiritual path. If they would have remained, the two new budgies would have helped these visionaries validate it before now. He said it was not my idea to start doing the reversals, and that I was being coached by the budgies to do them. In the final sentence, he says that God and the angels gave us permission to tell future events to help prove this is possible. So in part 21, he says, certainly, as often as we tell everybody, they'll soon understand there's reason his wife elevated his passion when she starts to understand. When superconscious spiritual birds support him, all else should have been validated with them. His support left, thinking he should have not reversed the translations when it was their parrots who were responsible coaching him. In part 23, he says, the parrots just told him it's okay and important to tell the future, so we can let you evoke the legend here. Then he will, and then in part 24, prove that the future is given here. The reverse of 24 will continue in the next section. Now you can hear parts 21 to 24. Going back to the last part, I want to mention that I do not believe that God is blaming the visionaries that I was working with at the time for the delays we have had over the years, because there were many times that I lost faith and made mistakes. I think the point that they are trying to make is the amount of effort that they've been putting into this. You will see as we do the translations from the other budgies how they have been working with me for almost 20 years to encourage and teach me. And I do not believe I would have been ready for this even 5 years ago. In parts 21 to 24, Victor mentions serious evil. If we really look closely at what is happening these days, we truly have to be concerned. For there is tremendous evil that is preventing us from realizing that we need to change in order for humanity to survive in the future. He says that because of this evil, God has given us permission to predict future events, and that this gift is to humanity. He says that this is the key, which could mean that if we do not have a better world in our future, humans may not have a world to come back to. If we approach it spiritually, then these good futures will be offered to humanity, and our planet will be saved by the interaction that God and the angels are providing. He has also said that Earth has been left as a gift for humanity. So in part 24, in reverse, he starts with, when involving serious evil, in part 25, you'll see God doesn't confine what he predicts. And your key is in heaven as a real gift. In part 26, he says, he cares there are better worlds for the future. In a good future, life is different if you approach it very spiritually. And then in 27 he says, these spiritual futures will be offered to a special world. Respect what you have, and you shall have one of the saved planets. And then I say, the Earth has been left here with you. Now you can hear parts 24 to 27.
What's the bird telling Victor?
In parts 28 to 30, he talks about how a broken future will affect us now, and that we should question things that do not help us to have a better future. He talks about the gifts the world will receive if you help us, and all you need is to support it with love. In the last part, he says there are evil people who are conspiring to ruin our world, and we will not listen to their evil mission. So in part 28, he says, if the future is a broken, dead world, it affects your world. We think you would question what is not helping. If you help with Ryan, there will be lots of gifts. In part 29, he says, the future is supporting pretty much people with love. We know you know it's a gift. In part 30, he says, evil people will have to know all the ploys you adorn to ruin your world. We won't listen to an evil mission. Now you can listen to the next part. In the last three parts of this video, Victor brings it all together and says that on this journey, they will be escorting Earth to a new beginning, and during that time, they will speak the truth. They talk about releasing a new religion that works for our time. Finally, he lets people know that if they care, they should be part of it, and if you do, you will regain real spirituality. So in part 31, he says, and we will care. So we'll escort Earth to a new beginning that's here, while telling the truth. We'll not fear the posts of you. And then I say, I'll sure know you're the one that's helping to let love in. In part 32, he says, it sure can start the right reactions. Some do believe that we are releasing a religion that works. In part 33, he says, can you really be caring? If you could be, you'd fight for the intern. Our future should have people that let you regain and help you feel real spirituality. So now you can hear the final part of this video.
People have to know the boy you adore? Yeah. Okay.
This completes this presentation. Thanks for listening. If you'd like to join us, you can come to theangelscrolls.com and click on to the forum link at the top, where we will be adding the newest presentations. Bye for now.